We'd like to thank the NFL Foundation for their generosity in making this course possible.
Hello, and thank you for joining me to discuss a critically important topic. My name is Dr. Craig Bryan. I'm a board-certified clinical psychologist who specializes in cognitive behavioral therapy. I'm also an Air Force veteran. While deployed, I was the clinical director of the Traumatic Brain Injury Clinic at the Air Force Theater Hospital in Balad, Iraq. Since leaving active duty in 2009, I have been researching suicidal behaviors and post-traumatic stress disorder in the military, and have been developing and testing the effectiveness of several interventions designed to reduce suicide risk and prevent suicide. I am the executive director of the National Center for Veteran Studies at the University of Utah. I speak with you today in all those roles. My goal for this course is to provide you with some vital information about the best evidence-based treatment technique available today. It's called the Crisis Response Plan, or CRP. This prevention and intervention strategy has been proven to save veteran lives. Over the past decade, suicides have more than doubled among members of the U.S. military. Veteran suicide rates have also reached epidemic proportions, and we are also now very worried about the increased suicide rates we are seeing in military family members. As family members, coworkers, caregivers, friends, and community members who support military service members, veterans, and their families, every one of us has an important part to play in the reduction of those suicide numbers. We all hope that we do not have to deal with crisis in those we care about, but sometimes things feel overwhelming and a person's ability to cope with his or her pain and stress feels too much to take. He or she is at great risk when this happens. During this critical time, the priority for any of us is to help stabilize that person. The Crisis Response Plan, or CRP, is a tool that can help you achieve that no matter what role you play in that person's life. It's also a tool that helps people help themselves to prevent these crises in the first place. The CRP is based on the factors we know protect people at risk for suicide. For more detailed information on risk and protective factors and what we can all do to help, please watch PsychArmor's courses entitled SAVE, Helping Others Hold On, and the other course in this series called What is the Crisis Response Plan? The CRP is based on a model called the suicidal mode, and it explains why some veterans become suicidal in reaction to a life event and others do not. First, some people are more vulnerable than others. This can include genetic or biological factors, psychiatric history, a history of impulsive behavior, among other factors. Second, some people are sensitive to triggers, such as a relationship or work problem or financial stress. These events can cause a crisis to occur. Those veterans with factors that make them vulnerable to risk are more likely to become suicidal when they experience a triggering event. Third, people often show certain symptoms when they become actively suicidal. Behaviorally, they might abuse substances, withdraw from other people, or harm themselves. Physically, they are often agitated and cannot sleep. They complain of concentration problems, and they experience physical pain. Emotionally, people say they feel shame, guilt, anger, and depression. Cognitively, which means the way someone thinks, veterans who feel suicidal say things to themselves like, "I'm a terrible person," "I'm a burden to others," and "things will never get better." We believe that what these veterans actually say to themselves and believe about themselves might be the most important way to know how at risk they are. In fact, research tells us that it is these beliefs that seem to predict who thinks about suicide versus those who attempt it. This is because those beliefs tend to be related to a lack of coping skills these veterans can use, including problem-solving techniques to use during a crisis. So where do you come in? I'm sure you've heard the saying, give a man a fish, you feed him today. Teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. We believe that every one of us connected to the military and veteran community can be part of the teaching the coping skills needed to change people's thinking and beliefs. The CRP helps us to do just that. It's important you know, the CRP is not a contract for safety. It's not a no-harm contract, and it's not a no-suicide contract. The CRP is not a contract at all. What is it then? It's a strategy for managing a crisis. If we're preventing one from getting worse, the CRP is typically handwritten on an index card. It is put together as a collaboration between you and the veteran or the person you are concerned about. It is a memory aid to help the veteran or person notice early stages of crisis and a checklist of personalized strategies to follow during a crisis. And it's a problem-solving tool. You might worry about bringing something like this up with the veteran or person you are concerned about. It is natural for people to feel unsure about something they don't understand. You can start by asking, what is one thing you would like to change about your situation? What would you like to be different in your life going forward? Remember to stay future-focused as you help them work through the plan and decide to create a CRP. The CRP has 5 sections. The first lists personal warning signs of crisis. The second details strategies for managing stress. The third names sources of social support. The fourth lists reasons for living, and the fifth includes emergency numbers. We will go over these in a bit more detail and give you ideas for ways to help the veteran or person you are worried about fill out each section. In the first section of the CRP, personal warning signs of a crisis are identified. These are written down so the veteran can learn to recognize early signs of a crisis before it gets worse. To help with this section, consider saying something like this. What happens that tells you things aren't going so well and are getting out of control? Or, if you wanted to prevent this from happening in the future, how do you know you're heading down this road? In the second section, strategies for managing stress are written down. These are activities or skills that the veteran has used successfully in the past. To help fill out this section, you might ask, when feeling upset or stressed, what are some things that help you to calm down or feel less stressed? Or what are some things you used to find helpful when stressed, even if you don't do them anymore? If the veteran you are helping struggles with this section, ask about strategies that have worked in the past. In the third section, sources of social support are written down. These might be family members, relatives, friends, or other people in the person's life who they can depend on or who help them feel better during times of need. Help by asking, when you feel stressed or upset, who helps to take your mind off those things or cheers you up? Or who do you know who provides you with support during tough times? Sometimes a veteran has trouble naming a person. If this happens, provide some general suggestions like family members or friends. If the veteran still cannot name someone, let him or her know that it's okay and move to the next section. In the fourth section, the veteran writes down reasons for living. These often look like things in our lives that give us a sense of purpose or meaning. Questions you can ask to help include, what gives you a sense of purpose and meaning in life? Or what stands in the way of you killing yourself? Some veterans struggle with this. Ask the individual to describe reasons for living in detail. If a veteran says there are no reasons for living, ask what things get in the way of a suicide attempt. In the last section, contact information for healthcare providers, therapists, crisis hotlines, and emergency services are recorded as a final safety net. Here you include the National Suicide Prevention Hotline, 1-800-273-8255, and press 1. Include go to the hospital or call 911 as the final step. We believe the CRP is so successful with military personnel and veterans for 3 reasons. 1, it focuses on reduction of suicide as the primary goal, regardless of the person's diagnosis. 2, it teaches veterans self-management strategies and empowers them to manage their distress and stop a crisis before it gets worse. 3, it places part of the responsibility on the veterans themselves, again giving them the belief that they can and will make a difference in their own lives in addition to asking for help from a professional. The crisis response plan works. There's a lot of research that shows that using the CRP leads to a reduction in suicide attempts. It does not have to be used by a healthcare provider or first responder. Anyone can help a veteran or anyone else who is struggling use this life-saving tool. For an introduction on the CRP, please visit the other course in this series entitled, What is the Crisis Response Plan? References are also found in the resource list for this course. On behalf of my team at the University of Utah, our collaborators at PsychArmor, and your active duty military and veteran coworkers, friends, family members, members of your communities and their families, thank you for taking the time to understand the crisis response plan and how to use it. Thank you for taking the first step in being part of this tool that has been proven to save veteran lives. And thank you for your willingness to be part of the solution for our country's heroes.
The Veterans Crisis Line number is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Please call 1-800-273-8255 and then press 1 if you or someone you know is in crisis or just wants to talk. If you have any questions or need assistance, go to the PsychArmor website or call the PsychArmor support line at 844-779-2427. Thank you for completing this course and taking that one step further in learning about our American veterans.